sell your belongings and give alms. Provide money bags for yourselves that do not wear out, and an inexhaustible treasure in heaven that no thief can reach nor moth destroy. For where your treasure is, there also will your heart be. Gird your loins and lighten your lamps, and be like servants who await their master's return from the wedding, ready to be told to open immediately when he comes and knocks. Blessed are those servants whom the master finds vigilant on his arrival. Amen, I say to you, he will gird himself, have them recline at the table, and proceed to wait on them. And should he come in the second or third watch, and find them prepared in this way, blessed are those servants. Be sure of this. If the master of the house had known the hour when the thief was coming, he would have not have let his house be broken in. You also must be prepared, for at the hour you do not expect, the Son of Man will come. Then Peter said, Lord, is this parable meant for us or for everyone? And the Lord replied, who then is the faithful and prudent steward whom the master will put in charge of his servants to distribute the food allowance at the proper time? Blessed is that servant whom his master on arrival finds doing so. Truly I say to you, the master will put the servant in charge of all his property. But if that servant says to himself, master is delayed in coming, and begins to beat the manservants and maidservants, eat and drink and get drunk, then that servant's master will come on an unexpected day and at an unknown hour, and will punish the servant severely and assign him a place with the unfaithful. That servant knew his master's will, but did not make preparations, nor act in accord with his will, shall be bitten severely. And the servant who was ignorant of his master's will, but acted in a way deserving of a severe beating, shall be bitten only lightly. Much will be required of the person entrusted with much, and still more will be demanded of the person entrusted with more. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Let us
listen. Wow, what a long Gospel, but long time no see. So we have God, we have forgotten that God, Jesus, not saying, okay, we can just do nothing, and then we'll get fed automatically. Not those kind of character. God gave us the opportunity, He gave us the ability, two feet, two hands, you know, to really do what we need to do. Get the job that we need to get, especially at this moment, many people have lost their jobs. And because some people, they have resolved either to return, or some of them have nowhere to go. Maybe Macau people, they lost their job, and they decide, or they tempted by to do something illegal to earn money because they have no other ways, or they thought this is the only way. So, meaning that we are not, Christians fall into this kind of problems. We are not fully trusting. We're afraid because we are taking our lives in our own hands. We have only trust in our ability. Without that forgotten, it was God who gave us that ability. So, for your Father, it's pleased, Jesus said, to give you the kingdom. So, we have the kingdom of this world, okay? But as we know it, it disappears, it is going to disappear, it is disintegrated, it is in chaos by the minute. So, it is not a safe place, really, anymore. It's not a safe place anymore, okay? Anybody could lose what they possess. But we are expecting not what we possess here. We are expecting and hoping to possess what God is giving us. He will give us the kingdom. Kingdom that is where we will be with Him. Starting now and ending up in heaven forever. So that is our goal. We always have to keep that in mind. No matter how we have to strive, earn money, keep up our living, stay alive. Because of the dangers or whatever that is causing us. You know, during this period, many people suffer so much. But still, suffering may be